Hi everyone, myself Dr. Jay Babu, consultant cardiologist, Columbia, Whitefield. Today we'll be discussing about heart attacks in young in India. So how common is heart attacks in India? People in India are now getting heart attacks much younger age. In fact, Indians get heart attack 8 to 10 years earlier than any other ethnic group all over the world. The most unfortunate fact among this is 40% of people in our country who develop heart attack are under the age of 55 years, out of which around 50% die of heart attack suddenly by sudden cardiac death. So what causes the premature heart attack? Three most important causes which you should know. One is tobacco consumption. Second is the family history of premature heart disease in parents or siblings. That is in men are less than 55 years and in women less than 60 years. And thirdly, diabetes. So women get heart attack approximately 10 years later than men. However, in women, especially diabetics or in smokers or who have family history of premature heart disease, then the women get heart attacks much earlier in premenopausal phase. The most common cause for premature heart disease by genetic origin is familial hypercholesterolemia, which you should know. So familial hypercholesterolemia is grossly underdiagnosed and undertreated in the community. One best way to do is a non-fasting lipid profile, wherein by knowing the LDL levels or the bad cholesterol level, you can diagnose this clinical entity. Since it is an autosomal dominant trait condition, so the family members who are involved, up to half of the family members would carry this gene. And if we can diagnose this at earlier age, we can prevent a lot of other premature heart attacks in the society. In these patients, at an early age, if we are able to start them on lipid lowering drugs like statins and along with lifestyle modification, we can definitely prevent a lot of premature heart attacks. The second reason being the tobacco consumption. Tobacco can be consumed in form of smoking, cigarettes, bidis, or smokeless tobacco, as we call the chewing tobacco. So this increases the risk for premature heart attacks because of inflammation of the coronary wall of the coronary arteries, and by the oxidation of the bad cholesterol, the LDL, and in turn increasing the platelet activity. All these together lead on to formation of clot, and that could lead on to blockage of coronary arteries, resulting in heart attack. The third risk factor being the diabetes. Diabetes is a very commonly associated risk factors, along with hypertension and lipid disorder. This can lead on to a premature heart disease. Diabetes also predisposes most for heart attack due to inflammation of the arterial walls of the coronary arteries and increased tendency for clot formation. So controlling the risk factors, all these risk factors like diabetes, hypertension, lipid disorders, will definitely prevent the genesis of the atherosclerosis or the plaque formation. And lifestyle management is a very important thing that is useful for controlling this, along with the drugs like statins, which lower the cholesterol, antihypertensives which control the blood pressure, and anti-diabetic drugs which control the diabetes. So all these things are essential. So how do we prevent a premature heart attack? Is we live in a very highly competitive environment with intense work demand. So all these increase the risk factors for heart disease, such as stress or incidence of diabetes, hypertension. All these things increase, along with this aggravating are the smoking and excessive consumption of alcohol, lack of sleep or lack of exercise. So lifestyle modification plays a key role in preventing the premature heart attacks. This is a very simple and affordable and effective way to treat, and all you have to do is just regularly do moderate intense aerobic exercise, just like brisk walking, cycling or jogging, probably even swimming 5 days a week. This is supposed to reduce your heart attacks by 30%. And if you reduce BP, control diabetes and lip, and it will also lead on to reduction in lipids. Other thing is diet. Diet predominantly what we are talking about is avoiding consumption, less consumption of trans fats and saturated fats. Trans fats is what is available with fast food centers, so your chips, cookies, all those things. So avoiding them. Saturated fats are basically ghee, butter, dalda. So all these things constitute saturated fats. So using them at a minimal allowable level, avoiding them or modifying them could definitely reduce your bad cholesterol. Other thing is smoking, as I told, reduction of smoking. So despite all these measures, among all these measures, lifestyle plays a major role in controlling in the risk factors, and use of the added statins, the diabetic anti-diabetic medicines and blood pressure medicines are also essential. So adapting these healthy habits, even when you start at a very younger age like childhood or adolescent, at a school level, is as essential in preventing preventing the premature heart attacks. That's it. Thank you.